Taking a look at two Star Wars The Vintage Collection 3.75-inch figures here today. We're going to look at the Armourer, and the Moff Gideon figure. So very first, very quickly, first of all, just some card back stuff. Nice image there from The Mandalorian of the Armourer. Gotta love the voice artist that does that work. She just fits the role so well. I'm sure it's someone else underneath, but there's the figure. We'll pop that open in just a second. VC179, we're going to take a look at quite a few of these figures here today. We'll get into them in just a minute and the following videos too. UPC should you need it. I picked mine up at DorksideToys.com. You can find a link to buy it from them in the under the description in the video below. And they've got a bunch of stuff on sale today. It's actually New Year's Day here for me, and they've got a bunch of cool figures, including the Bespin playset on clearance already. I've not even got around to reviewing the damn thing yet. Anyway, we've got a couple of little tongs inside for her firing up the grill, the barbecue. Let's get a look at the figure just first of all. I'll zoom in with some light on this. Looks nice. They've added some weathering to the helmet, which is nice. Gives it a nice chrome dome effect, and the same on the kind of Jon Snow-like, or every character in Game of Thrones when they're going up north. They have these kind of heavy sheep. Your back must be so sweaty with something like that. Anyway, and your a furnace right next to you. Kind of nuts, never mind. And that nice coppery kind of coloured effect on that Mando chest piece is nice. Lots of nice little touches too. Gold and silver here and there, and little belt greeblies and bits and pieces. She's nice, looks good. And the skirt piece has got some weathering on it too, which is nice too. It's kind of hard to see, but they've added a nice touch of weathering there. Gives it a really cool leathery look. And she's got those cool big thick boots with those toes on them. Nice looking little figure, like it. And very similar to her big sister effect. This one didn't really get as much weathering as the smaller one, which is kind of different, and we don't get any of the paint on the kind of mole-like tips up there. But the same consistency on the belt, the same on the weathering of the skirt piece, although quite a tonally a different colour. Same for the pants and the boots. And look at that, it's kind of interesting. You'd think there'd be some consistency between the two. Very weird. Why did one get brass bits and the other one didn't? I mean, really? Anyway, very strange. You're a strange bunch. And there's pink. You'd think, again, they'd have palette colours for, you know, the fluffy bit in her back is X colour. Weird. Very, even the skirt's just so different. So I don't understand what they do. And there's stripes down the 6-inch version, but not in the 3.75. So, okay, you know, kind of weird. It is a smaller figure, and sometimes paint is skipped, but it's kind of annoying to see that one gets some paint. It's just so different. It's a bit a little odd. But there you go. So in terms of articulation on her, she's pretty good. Ball joint on that head, plenty of rotation all the way around. You cannot, I believe, take this off because it's glued on, so don't try and do that like I did, and then you kind of break the plastic. So you're kind of limited with your arms. You can really only move them up, otherwise you're going to get rip that glue off the back. So yeah, you're talking, it'll be elbows that you'll be moving on this figure, but some really nice articulation on them. So ball joint there, ball joint at the hinge on the elbow, I should say. Swivel wrist and back and forth on them too. She's got a really nice little ab waist swivel. And underneath that skirt, or the flap, always about the flaps, is kind of unusual little pegs there. I've not seen that in a while. Maybe I've just not seen so many 3.75 figures. Swivel up at the top of the hips, single joint at the knees, no boot cut because it's a small figure, but rocking ankles and tiny peckles. Cool little figure. And the two weapons are very, standard stuff. And not too dramatically different from the bigger figures, although again, very different colours and much more gunmetal on the 6-inch figure, much more realistic looking on the 6-inch, but otherwise the same. That is that figure. Let's go look at Moff Gideon, or Thin Bill Cosby, as we call him on the 6-inch show. As part of our kind of end of year celebrations, we're talking about this figure, and yeah, he's just, that facial sculpt's just kind of weird, and yet bizarrely, this version, the 3.75 version, is kind of better. Excuse me. than the 6-inch version, photos wise. I don't have it yet. I think it just came into stock at Darkside, or was about to. I'm sure it was. But they were good. Look at the size of that blaster. This was ridiculously tiny. Teeny tiny. Barely on a fingernail. God. That's small. Okay, let's go look at the card first of all. So we've got a nice picture of the actor there. Bit grainy and dark though. But it is to accentuate the Darksaber, I guess. Which it does really show. He's on top of his TIE fighter. That sequence we saw at the end of the show. The Mandalorian on the card. The VC-180. And again, most of these or all of them will be reviewed shortly. And the UPC, should you need it, is there. And again, you want to buy it? Link to buy it. Description below. So, his blaster, his tiny, tiny little, I'm going to lose this and choke a cat blaster, goes into a working holster. Working holster on a 3.75 inch figure, but some 6 inches they mold them in. Makes no sense. The Darksaber blade has really got a touch of silver or white around. I think it's white, actually. And it's, come on, there we go. And it's kind of nicely done. It's really hard to paint on that size. I do agree with them. So it's not perfection, but it is hard to do. The handle looks quite nicely done. If you've seen the 6-inch one, I saw one. I was kind of tempted when I was on Darkside. They had it for sale, and we were posting about it. I was like, oh, it looks kind of good. It looks kind of nice. I'm very addicted to Mando stuff, as I'm sure all of you are. So Bill Cosby here is not looking quite as Bill Cosby. He's looking a little closer to that actor, as I said, but the 6-inch one is just not right. I'm not quite sure what went on here, but facial sculpt, facial scan, close but no cigar. But not too bad on the 3.75. It turned out not too shabby at all. We get some nice TIE Fighter-esque kind of chest plating going on, which is really nice. And the little straps that hold it on. And the kind of morph belt. There's some really nice little details on that, which is lovely. Same on the matching gauntlets, gloves. It's a nice little touch. And the back, huge peg hole. Which would have been great to put the blade, actually, but nope. It's a gigantic, but why did they do that? I wonder why. But there we go. So standard stuff, same articulation on him pretty much as the armor, but a lot more movement. And the nice thing about these arm shoulder flat pieces are it allows them to move up, so you do get a lot more room and maneuverability about them. Same articulation, same joints, same movability on each one. Ab crunch and all the rest of it, and underneath that little camel tiny teeny skirt, I see the same details there, the thighs and the joints at the knee, and rocking ankles and tiny little peckles. So he looks pretty good. Let's, of course, the cape. What am I thinking? I'm just on drugs here. Sorry, guys. It's, I need some caffeine. There we go. So that plugs into, I wonder why is he got a hole in his back? Yes, I'm on drugs. So, pop that little Darksaber in his hand. He's looking pretty good. That's quite a good looking little figure. I do like that. It's really catching the blade and the paint on that side, which is probably the best, it has to be said. So that's looking pretty good. Pretty good for a 3.75 inch figure. And nice little details of the blue and the yellow. So yes, Moff Gideon is pretty tasty. Quite a good looking 3.75 inch figure. As is the armor. Do like these two figures. So there you go. Two Mandalorian 3.75 inch vintage collection figures. And they're really good. They're really well done. This one particularly really stands out with all the extra details that get lacked on the 6-inch one. And I do love that chromey kind of helmet. And the facial sculpt there is pretty neat. So, yeah. Cracking 3.75 inch figures from The Mandalorian. Let us know what you think in the comments below. If you like it, give it a thumbsy up. It'd be great. And we'll see you for more videos and reviews. More vintage collection coming right up.